fuck am I gonna start this shit out? Alright. Not gonna bullshit about it, not gonna argue, not gonna talk about it. I have a very complex personality that a lot of people can honestly sit there and say that they find extraordinarily annoying. And regardless how that may sound or that may look, I've always managed to have some form of connection with people that, as a lot of people would consider, baggage. And truth be told, the origin of how I met this person, like, is some shit straight out of a fucking movie. Like, it's backwards as fuck. Like, it's like, and it was crazy, is that I started to notice it, and I've been doing it subconsciously for such a long time. Well, since it ended, I guess. And the old wives' tale goes, you never know what you have until it's gone. And when I think on what me and this person had been through together, like, it wasn't anything we never did that we didn't handle together, you know what I'm saying? Like, even as I remain unstable, both mentally and physically, I still would stand by this person. Like, I don't believe people should be chastised for their past or what they've done previously or in a previous life. You know, I never had that mentality. But I realized, like, our communication has been lackluster. Partially my fault. And it's funny. I've known this person for a year and some change. No. 2 years, actually. And honestly, I could not ask for a better person in my life. Like, even if I move on, even as I move on in my life, like, I still, like, have those memories of us being around one another and just, like, having literally out of left field conversations. Like, we would just chill together, just be talking and playing video games, playing Fortnite and shit, and I'm just like, there's something about this person. But I fucked that up, of course. It's funny. I'm laughing at it now because it's like, I visually saw what I should have physically saw. You know what I'm saying? I saw someone that was willing to put their all into me, and I fucked that up. And it's, like, low-key depressing. Like, for real. Like, out of every person that I've ever hurt, or that has hurt me, every time that if this person and I were to continue being around each other, I could honestly sit there and say that I would deal with it because I deeply care and deeply love this person. And this person stood with me through all of my bullshit. You know, big mama drama, drama at home, drama at work. And it's like, it's hard just to hear their name these days. Like, I want to call them sometimes and I just be like, nah. I stop myself, like, because I'd be like, nah, they don't want to hear me. They don't want to hear my voice and shit. So, popped at this conversation, told them, you know, give me a time off, you know, type shit. So, told me can't do that for this, that, and that reason, obviously because of work, and clearly COVID-19 is still a problem. Still a progressive thing, which means finances need to be very finances could be scarce depending on how the situation turns out. And with all intended purpose in my soul, like, I will not let this person go through that. I don't want to do that to them. But we agreed on a conversation. Like, mind you, we haven't spoken in like almost a month. Like three and a half weeks now. Truth be told, I'm nervous about having this conversation with them because I'm like, it's not going to be reciprocated. It's going to be a waste of time on both ends. Like, it's going to be ignored, whatever have you. But I want this person back in my life because, like, aside from having a son, like, me personally, don't get me wrong, I never thought about marriage, kids, and shit like that. But having a son in my previous life, my son gave me a drive to do better. And this person saw I could do better when I couldn't see it in myself. I personally never had faith in myself. And it's not depression or nothing like that. I just, like, I know from how I grew up, life in school, life in the streets, you know what I'm saying? And everything up until the point of where I met this person, you know, I was just coming out of a relationship. And a coworker between the two of us, you know, introduced us to each other, and we just had, like, a little random conversation, you know. Told him, come meet me, you know, we're going to come upstairs, type shit. So, where I was working at the time, we talked for about an hour. It's cool. It was like, they opened themselves up to me, and they was like, how life really is for them, like, hearing their family life story and shit like that. And I realized how fucking similar we really were. Like, this person's mother was going through cancer, and I recently lost my father. Like, literally, it was coming up on, like, literally, it had just passed, like, yeah, it had just passed a year, actually. It actually had just passed 2 years since I lost my father. And we just, you know, clicked after that. So it's like, I gave myself a time limit because everything that's going on with music and shit, you know, I've lost a lot of people in my corner, and it seems like that is the problem. Like, don't nobody want to do work together no more. And, you know, even when I was going through my shit with them, even when I lost Silence, it's like, this person was there. They were with me. And, you know, I had my son and his mother supporting me through this as well. Like, you know, there's no denying that I have, like, a certain amount of people that are behind me, that support me. Not support like that. Like, obviously coming from my son and his mother is, like, just genuine. But I want that person to understand that, like, I'm here. And this will probably be the one and the final time that I do this. So, we're gonna see what happens.